It's been a breakthrough year for OneDrive for Business. We unified the sync client for OneDrive Personal and Business on both PC and Mac. We delivered a new modern web experience, shipped 4-star and above rated mobile apps across iOS, Android, and Windows Phone, and we built lots of new admin and security controls for IT. Today, I'm going to show you how OneDrive for Business, as part of Office 365, provides simple, powerful file sharing and collaboration across all your devices. Backed by the cloud leadership of Microsoft in security, IT control, privacy, and compliance. And we'll also cover what we're doing to make OneDrive the window to all your files in Office 365, regardless of whether they're in OneDrive, Office 365 groups, or SharePoint. And how we're adding new intelligent experiences for trending and suggested content and insights into the impact and reach of your work. To begin, we'll look at the life of a file. It starts with an individual who creates it to drive a desired business outcome. For example, a sales proposal. And that person then needs to get others to contribute ideas, feedback, and expertise to the file. Organizations want to give their people a place to put all these files and allow them to share and collaborate as they need, both internally and externally, on any device. And this is OneDrive's role. Let me show you this in action. I'll play the role of a salesperson at Contoso who needs to put together a compelling sales proposal for a customer, Fabricam. So like many people, I've got multiple devices. At home, I tend to work with a Mac, and I'm issued a PC from work where I do the bulk of my work, including budgets, campaign plans, and proposals. So on the Mac here, I sync all of my files for my personal photos and documents. I've also got some of my work files here. So you'll see that I can actually go in and selectively pick the folders that I want to take offline. So I can optimize this for different devices, different purposes, and different capacity. You'll also notice that I actually sync Redmond Raiders Football Club. I'm the secretary for the club, and we actually use Office 365 for managing that. So let's go into the work, and I'm going to go and create a new sales proposal for Fabricam. So I pick it based on an existing template. Now all I need to do is actually go in and start to fill in that information. And when I save that, I'm going to save that to OneDrive for Business. And I've got a proposals folder here. So I'll call this Fabricam proposal. Go ahead and save that now. And then the final thing that I want to do is I need to get some expertise and help with the pricing section from a colleague of mine, Omar. So I'm going to go in and invite Omar to this document. It will find all of the matching entries for Omar. Please help with pricing section. And go ahead and share that. So now when I'm in the office, I use my Windows laptop and I want to be able to work on the same document quickly and easily. You'll see here that I have actually got a different range of folders that I sync on my PC. So here we are here. Here's my OneDrive for Business listed out, and I've got a set of folders that I use when I'm actually in the office. You'll also notice that although I'm syncing my personal files, I'm not syncing any of that not-for-profit, the Raiders FC, that I had on my Mac. So let's go into that proposal and actually go in and continue to work with it. So here we are here, and I can actually see that Omar is already in the document and applying changes. If I want to, I can actually go in and trigger a Skype conversation directly from within Word if we want to have a discussion about certain sections. I've also got the ability to actually go and share with others, again, directly in the Office app. And I've got a view of all of the activity that's been going on. So I know when specific versions have been set, what actions other users have actually taken. So I've got a really super productive experience. If I want to, I can also go in and add new comments as conversation and review with Omar. So again, all of these features are unique to OneDrive for Business, which provides the most seamless Office integration. Now, if I prefer to work in the browser, I've got a great experience there too. As you'll see, I've got a really simple list view. I can switch between tiles, so I've got a thumbnail preview of all of the key files that I'm working with. I can also go in and actually have a look at my recent files. I can have a look at the files that have actually been shared with me, and I can even access my recycle bin if I need to recover accidentally deleted files. So let's go in and have a look at that proposal. So you'll see it's laid out there. There's the Fabricam proposal file. Now, as I select that, you'll see up the top, I've got a contextual array of options. So if I want to, I can open in Word Online or Word. I can also go ahead and share that file, get a link to embed within an email, and there's various other functions as well. I can also have a look at the version history for that file. And if I want to, I can go into what we call the information pane. And it's going to give me a rich preview of that particular file. I can see all of the recent activity. I can see the sharing information, so who I've actually shared with. So there's the Omar share that I did before, plus the ability to copy quick links to go and send to others if I want to collaborate with them. So as you've seen, OneDrive for Business allows me to get my work done quickly and efficiently. But this is quite often just the first stop on a longer journey. At some point, people may want to publish or distribute their files, make them available for a broader audience for viewing, feedback, or approvals. And this is SharePoint's role with a team site or Office 365 group. So what motivates people to copy or move their files? Often, it's due to organization-mandated processes. But also, people just want to make their work broadly discoverable, reviewed, liked, shared, all the reasons why Facebook and Instagram have been such big social phenomena. And this is where we're investing, making it simple to copy and move between the file management solutions in Office 365, OneDrive for Business, Groups, and SharePoint, and making them accessible and actionable from a single set of desktop, browser, and mobile experiences. So in our story, I want to publish this sales proposal and make it available for others to reuse. It builds my brand and stature as a subject matter expert. Let's start with the simple process of copying files from OneDrive for Business to SharePoint or Office 365 groups. We'll be shipping this experience in the coming months. So here's the proposal I'm working on with Omar, and what I want to do is copy that off to our pipeline management team site for broader review. All I need to do is pick the documents and the proposals folder and choose that location. Now it's actually going to copy that over to the SharePoint team site. And when I click on that, it's actually going to take me to that particular team site. And there's the document there. So we've clearly got a great experience on the PC or Mac on both the desktop and browser to enable people to work together more effectively. We're going to continue to deliver simple and powerful experiences for PC and Mac by ensuring that you can sync any file stored in any SharePoint site or Office 365 group. And this capability will be delivered towards the end of the year, starting with a preview in the third quarter of 2016. So let me show you how simple and powerful the mobile experience is. To be the window to all your files in Office 365, the most important device to have a fast and simple experience is your phone. And to date, over 100 million people have downloaded our mobile apps and rated them highly on all the mobile platforms. We have a lot in store for them, and today I'll show you some new mobile features and capabilities for accessing and sharing files that we're shipping today. Firstly, for iOS, I'm going to show you how the OneDrive app not only gives me anywhere, anytime access to my OneDrive files, it now gives me access to all of my SharePoint files, the ones I care about. I'm able to do all of the things I typically want to do on my phone, view, edit, share, upload, and even take files offline when I'm disconnected. So here's my iPhone, and I have the OneDrive app installed. And you can see I've got all my files and folders that I've been working on, including that proposal, Fabricam proposal, that I've been working on with Omar. So I can go in, open that particular file in the Office application, and it's really straightforward. You also see that Omar's actually still editing that document. Very, very powerful capabilities. I can also do things like search across all of my OneDrive. I can go into all of my recent files. And now I can actually go and access the SharePoint sites. So there's that pipeline management site that we copied it to. If I drill into the proposals folder, there's the Fabricam proposal. So I can access all of the files that I care about, regardless of whether they're in OneDrive or in SharePoint. As I mentioned, this iOS update is available today. You can start to see where our vision and strategy for OneDrive is taking shape. We're the only solution that lets users connect to their individual cloud storage and SharePoint files all in the one simple, powerful experience. And this is just the first step. We'll bring the same experience to the Android app and Windows Phone later this year. So stay tuned for announcements on that. Now let me show you how we've gone beyond just simple file sync and share. We're driving usage of these tools by appealing to people's desire to not only get their work done, but also be recognized for that work. We're moving beyond utility file storage and bringing insights and intelligence to recommend content and provide compelling feedback on the impact and reach of your work. Let's look at some of the new intelligent experiences that we're delivering today. So firstly, in the Android app, again, I can access all of my files and folders, including that proposal that we've been working on. But what we're shipping today is a new Discover view. And this uses the power of the Office Graph to deliver me suggested and relevant and trending content that might be useful for my job. It means that I don't have to search for files, files find me. We're also delivering the same experience into the browser, and we'll be shipping that in the coming months. So that's how we're bringing you intelligent experiences, similar to Delve, to bring you relevant content directly in the mobile app. Our other goal is to help you measure the impact of your work. So let me give you a first look at what we're shipping later this year. We're doing to files what Instagram did to photos. We tap into people's desire for self-expression and recognition, to be noticed and valued for their contribution. Not only can I publish from OneDrive to SharePoint, but I want to, for the visibility and discoverability that SharePoint offers. So we're providing a means for people to review and measure the impact and reach of their work. Again, we harness the power of the Office Graph and machine learning to make this possible, and all of it delivered as part of a single mobile app experience. So here I am in the mobile app, and I've got all my files and folders, as you've seen before, but we'll have a section there where I can actually go and do analytics around the impact and reach of the files I'm creating. So if I go into Analytics, I can view all of my files, and on the right-hand side, you'll see the total number of views of that content and how it's trending over time. So if I tap into a file, the blue line, the top line, gives me a breakdown of the total views over time for this particular file. And if I pick a particular date, it will tell me, in this case, March 11, I had 16 total views of that file. The line below gives me the unique number of viewers. So 4 viewers on that date have looked at my file 16 times. And I can see all of the trends around whether more people are starting to look at this particular file, and I'm really measuring the impact of my work. So there you have it. You've seen some of the simple and powerful capabilities we offer today across PC, Mac, browser, and mobile to make people productive in creating, collaborating on, and publishing their files in Office 365. Today, we've released some amazing new experiences to deliver insights and intelligence to the way you work, and provided a glimpse of how we're moving beyond simple file sync and share with analytics to measure the impact and reach of your work. You can get started with most of this stuff today. The iOS app to connect to your SharePoint document libraries is now available on the App Store, and the new Discover experience in the Android app is now available from the Play Store. All the other new features we showed, including the Discover view and the copy to SharePoint in the browser, will roll out in the coming months. As always, give us your feedback on onedrive.uservoice.com and stay tuned for more exciting announcements on OneDrive for Business later this year. Thanks for watching.